In this video, we will learn how to cite a website using the References tool in Microsoft Word 2013. Once you've placed your cursor at the end of your website quotation, paraphrase, or summary, click the References tab. Check that the style says APA. If it doesn't, click the drop-down menu and select APA 6th edition. Select Insert Citation, then Add New Source. In the Type of Source drop-down menu, select Website. The most difficult part of citing websites is locating all the information you need to properly cite it. You may have to search around for the information. If you aren't able to find all the necessary information on your web page, try hunting around on the home page or the About page. The first piece of information you need to cite your website is an author. To properly cite the author's name, click the Edit button next to the Author field. Type the author's last name and first name. If the author uses their middle initial, type that in as well. To add another author, click the Add button. Depending on what kind of web source you are citing, you may find an author name that appears as a one-word username. When this is the case, put the username in the last name field, keeping the username's original capitalization. Once you have added all the authors, click OK. Sometimes, there is no individual author for a website. In this case, checkmark the box next to Corporate Author, then type the name of the organization who is responsible for the website. If you are able to find names of individual authors, do not fill in this field. Next, type the name of the specific web page you are citing in the Name of Web Page field, capitalizing only the first word of the title, subtitle, and proper nouns. Leave the Name of Website field blank. Be as specific as possible when inputting the date of publication. Type the year in the year field, spell out the name of the month, then type the specific day. If there is no publication date available, leave the year, month, and day fields blank. You may only be able to find a year. That's okay. Type in the year and leave the month and day fields blank. Finally, copy the URL of the web page, or if it's multiple pages, to the entry page or home page, and paste it in the URL field. Click OK. At CentralPen, you are required to include page numbers, or in the case of websites, paragraph numbers, in your in-text citations. To do that, click on your in-text citation, then click the arrow that appears. Select Convert Citation to Static Text. After the year, place a comma and a space, then type PARA period. After one more space, type the paragraph number. If you are citing multiple paragraph numbers, separate the numbers with a dash and no spaces. Make sure that the spacing around your in-text citation is correct. It should be separated from the rest of your sentence by one space and be followed by a period. Once you have finished all of your in-text citations, you will be ready to create your references page. At the end of your essay, begin a new page, then type the word References on the first line. Center the title. On the next line down, align your cursor to the left, then click the References tab, Bibliography, then Insert Bibliography. Make sure you double-check your citations. You are the one responsible to turn in correct citations, not Microsoft. To correct this citation, I will highlight it, change the font to Times New Roman, size 12, and make sure that it is double-spaced. If you have questions about using the References tool in Microsoft Word 2013, contact the library.